Mayor first and then manager.
What's that?
We'll do the mayor first and then the manager. Were you asking both?
No, I just didn't know how they were.
Yeah, we're going to the mayor first and then we might have to switch to the manager and send on the question, but ideally mayor question first.
How you doing?
I'm good. How are you doing?
Yeah. All right, we've heard the audit. There's quite a lot there to digest. Your initial reaction.
Well, you know, initially I'm disappointed, obviously, with the poor rating, but it's understandable. I mean, we have had a lot of things that we've had to address at the city, and you know, I can't say enough great things about our city staff and the effort that they've had to put forward, not only with the tornado, but now the audit for the last number of months, almost 8 months, and you know, we know a lot of the information there, obviously, and we're aware of it prior to. And we really have an opportunity as a city, as city leadership, to make those changes and to continue our growth forward in this great community. We will be a better run community. We will be a more prosperous community. We will be a more efficient community because of the results of this audit and because of the changes that we're already implementing in city government.
I think kind of the elephant in the room concerned about the indictments, that kind of thing, the criminal process.
You know, that's beyond my scope, and obviously if something like that would happen, we would have to address that. But right now, you know, we're dealing with the things that are right in front of us, and at this point in time, we don't have those things to deal with at this point, and hopefully we don't.
Mayor, you're not going to be a better teacher. You're not going to be a better teacher walking out of the office than you are on the bus.
We're going to win selecting the
Well, obviously, if those allegations are factual, that is a flawed process, and we don't condone that. But what I can tell the citizens right now, we have absolutely no plan now or ever in the future to use a national developer. So a lot of those processes, a lot of those situations that have happened, techniques were used. Obviously, that is not something that we would condone. But moving forward, we see no need for a national developer. We know it was not a success from the standpoint of redevelopment. There were some things that a master developer did do early on, but when you grade them on what comes out of the ground, you know, obviously we were not satisfied. I definitely do not like the way they abandoned our community and abandoned their employees. But through all of that, the city continues to grow. We have projects that they were working on. There were two. We just reissued an RFP for the memory care facility. That project is back on track, hopefully, with proposals. So that project was one of their identified projects that they were hoping to complete. We will be able to complete that with successful process through the city. The other one is the commercial development next to the library. And, tomorrow that has stopped us from continuing that process on that commercial development. So, in spite of all of our jolly leaving this community, we are a community on the move, and we are a community looking forward and looking forward to the future.
I'm